Hi, Mark Moserman from NEUROSPEC Switzerland. Today we're not in Switzerland, we're in Germany. As you can see, we're here in the facilities of Shimadzu, the creator of NIRS. So let's go inside and have a look what we're going to do today, because the aim of the game is to record EEG and NIRS together in a single file. Come on, follow me. Ah, Anne, how are you?
Hi, Mark. Nice to see you. Great. Welcome to the Shimadzu European headquarters.
Beautiful, beautiful.
Let's start in our laboratory world here, in our European headquarters. And as you might know, Shimadzu has been founded already 1875. We are currently more than 13,000 people worldwide.
Impressive.
We are specialized on analytical and measuring instrumentation, as well as medical devices, like the functional near infrared spectroscopy system, so our FNIRS. And so we go now over here to our demo room.
Fantastic.
Where we can start the multimodal measurement.
Oh, can't wait.
Where I'm looking for.
Beautiful, beautiful.
Yes, so yeah, welcome here. We can go over to Rio.
Ah, wonderful. Rio!
Hi, Mark.
Konnichiwa.
Konnichiwa.
How are you?
Good
to see you.
Very good. Good to see you too.
Thank you. Thank you for inviting us to come to the Shimadzu. This is fantastic, because today we're going to do EEG and NIRS as a combined measurement. But please, Rio, explain what we've got on the table on the NIRS side.
Of course. This is our light NIRS system, compact portable FNIRS systems. Of course, we have a much bigger system, which is called lab NIRS. This is very compact, but still it's as powerful and stable as the lab NIRS systems. Let me explain the specification of light NIRS shortly. This system has the capability of 22 channels with 8 source and 8 detectors probes. Blue probes is the detectors with the avalanche photodiode. And the red one is the probes of the emitters, which has the 3 wavelength lasers. So this system is compact, but still high sensitivity from those devices. And we have here the standard type A and the type B holders. Also, we have the baby cap.
So they would look essentially similar to these, just less holders,
just the,
obviously, right?
Just a small size with the same configurations.
Okay, I see. Mm-hmm.
And we have also the EEG and FNIRS simultaneous measurement cap.
Yep.
So we're going to show later the measurement with this cap. Currently, we are connecting the light NIRS with the AC power adapter, but we can also use offer the battery pack.
Oh, excellent. So complete.
Portable.
Oh, fantastic.
Mm-hmm. And at the same time, we can connect both the wired cable and also the wireless with the between the computer and light NIRS.
Oh, that's
systems.
Excellent. That's excellent. So you're completely free from any mains, or you can walk around, etc. Excellent.
Mm-hmm. Also, we can offer the optional software for FNIRS overlaying with the MRI data.
Oh, excellent.
And also, this is possible. We can see the FNIRS signals simultaneously with the on the MRI data.
Wow. And that's real time.
Exactly.
Oh, that's excellent. And of course, offline, you can do this.
Of course.
Yes. And so that's the acquisition running there on this laptop, which can, of course, run on a big desktop as well. That is not limited.
Course, absolutely. Mm-hmm.
Well, that's excellent. So let me walk over to my side, where the EEG resides from Biosemi. I'm going to explain, as Rio did with the NIRS side, I'm going to do the EEG. Again, thank you, Rio, for the intro of the light NIRS, which is a very, very powerful system. But even more powerful now that we can actually combine EEG and NIRS. So we have the Active 2. The Active 2 obviously can boast with 256 channels, plus 8 extra channels, plus of course a whole lot of sensors. My system has inbuilt ABR, so we can also do auditory evoked potential. We will be using 32 channels today. We have here this purple new USB receiver, which has existed for a couple of years, but now has been modified. And any future edition of the USB receiver will already include that modification, so anybody can do NIRS as well. We have here ActiveView, and we have actually a splitter cable. And this splitter cable, which connects to the USB receiver port, actually provides the following. We have number one, as in the past, we have 8 bits coming in through stimulation programs such as E-prime, presentation, superlab, stim, RT, etc., etc., into the USB receiver, and we have 8-bit triggers in the acquired EEG. From inside the USB receiver, we split an output and we feed two markers or two triggers to the NIRS acquisition. So what we do is, and that is paramount, that we start NIRS acquisition first. We start saving the file. And as soon as that's happening, we will see that with Joanna when we do the acquisition. We will start saving the file on this side on the Active2 software. So as soon as Active2 starts to store the file, we will be sending number one a marker over there to know this is when NIRS starts. And then we also provide second triggers. So every second we send the trigger to ActiveView and the second trigger to the NIRS. Once we've done and we finished our acquisition, we will end up with two files. We'll have a BDF file and we will have an OMM file. Yes, I know, it's a different file, but you will transfer it into an OMM file. That's very, very important. So that OMM file will consist of a starter trigger, and it will consist of second triggers sent from the USB receiver over to the NIRS. Same, and in the same point of time, we send it to ActiveView when the data of the EEG comes in. When we finished, we pull the two files together as a zipper principle. That is what Kuhn Mettingman-Rien, that's the director of Biosemi, told me, which is a very, very good analogy. We have like a zipper where we need to make sure that we have a starting point where the two zippers come together, and then we need to align these markers, which are the second markers that we send to both of these acquisitions. When we finished, we have one file consisting of oximetry, consisting of EEG, and we have a very, very powerful result at hand, which we can then analyze and do whatever we want to do with this file. So I think that's it. We've spoken enough. Now let's set up our subject. Ryu, my colleague, is holding the combined NIRS EEG cap, which is beautifully made because it includes the NIRS holders and includes the EEG holders. The EEG holders are all labeled, so I know where to put all the active electrodes in of the Active2 from Biosevi. So please, Ryu, would you set up the cap on Joanna's head? Mind you, while he's doing that, I want to explain something very important, because that question always arises. Are there different cap sizes for the combined cap? And the answer is no, because it's a very complex cap, as you can see. It needs to be stable due to the optodes that we actually put into this cap, or as Shimadzu called it, a combined holder for EEG and NIRS. What we can do though is we can readjust those little NIRS holders with the little wheels. So we can tighten them and just move the cap into place to fit the actual shape of the head and also the size of the head. Has set up the optodes to the left and to the right. I set up 32 channels and we have started the recording on the NIRS. We have now also started the recording on the Active2, and very important to know this, that this is so important for the synchrony of the file, because the Active2 sends over 1 second markers to the NIRS, and that's going to be embedded in the file. So when we do the merging, that's all going to be in synchrony. And I think at this point in time, Joanna can start with the huge challenge of Jenga. Bravo, very good. Okay, the Jenga has fallen. The acquisition is concluded. We will free Joanna from the cap. But before we do, I want to explain again what we did. So we recorded the EEG from the cap. We recorded the NIRS with these optodes, which Rio has set up. We have sent time markers over to the NIRS file. They're the 1 second trigger markers. From the active two, which will allow us to actually merge the two files and have one file with absolute synchrony, which is a first, really, because we can do it. We can do it in full synchrony. We can change the sampling of the actual NIRS file to accommodate to the EEG file. And so that's going to be an incredible analysis, which we will do. But at this point in time, we want to thank you, Joanna, again, for being our participant, and Rio for setting this up with me. And so that concludes the acquisition. Well, this was a brilliant day. Again, Ryu, thank you so much. It was brilliant.
Thank you.
Thank you for explaining the NIRS in depth. That was very, very interesting. It's a fantastic system.
Thank you.
The EEG side, Biosemi has created an incredible tool to bring the two data sets together. That is absolutely super. At this point in time, I also want to thank Anne-Christine, who participated, Joanna, who did this incredible Jenga thing. Hope the data is going to turn out really well.
Yep.
You subscribe to our channel, that would be absolutely beautiful. Thank you for watching. Thank you for taking the time. We'll see you again. We will analyze the file and, of course, bring that in as well. But at this point in time, just like to say goodbye. Thank you for watching.